Welcome back, everybody. This is me drawing every day for a year, week 52 plus 7. So let's get into it. So this first spread was done on the subway. I was going down to Union Station here in Toronto, and as I always do on these long commute trips, I try to sketch somebody on the subway. And this particular gentleman was sleeping, and I got him in my larger sketchbook. He just had an air about sleeping there for the long haul, so that's why I used my fountain pen and my large sketchbook to depict the scene. On a side note, as I was nearing completion of this drawing, this lady was exiting the subway, and she stopped, and she said to me, "Oh, I wish I could do something like that." And I looked at her and I said, "It's all practice." And I honestly believe that anybody could draw, anybody could paint. It's just putting in the hours. And I had a professor, I think I've related this story to you in past videos, where his name was Richard Juice. He drew like the wind. He was an amazing drawer, sketcher, painter. And I had a similar sentiment. I said a similar sentiment to him way back when, and he said, "You know what you do, Will? You start off 5 minutes every day. Just do that consistently. 5 minutes, 5 minutes, 5 minutes. And eventually those 5 minutes will turn into 10, and those 10 minutes will turn into 15, and those drawing sessions will grow longer and longer. And that's how you get better. You do it consistently and for larger amounts of time, over time." So that's my secret, if it is a secret, to anybody who wants to draw or draw better. Okay, so let's hop into my smaller sketchbook. Let's zoom in. So here's my smaller sketchbook. When I hit Union Station, it was quite busy when I got down there, and there was one seat across from these two gentlemen. So I thought this was a perfect opportunity to sketch it and practice my sort of mid-range view of these guys. So I didn't, because of where they were sitting and what tool I was using, the ballpoint pen, I couldn't really get into the nitty-gritty of the details of each of these subjects, nor should I have, because if I, you know, sketched every whisker on this guy's upper lip and, you know, sketched every fold in his jacket, it would have, I think, looked like a muddled mess. So it's all about figuring out what's important and what's not in a drawing, and putting those important lines down and just getting the overall form. So hopefully I'm working towards editing myself and learning how to edit better. So that's one of my goals for every time I do a drawing, is to edit. A quick sketch of a person sleeping on the subway, and he must have gotten up and left, or I must have hit my stop. A guy, I believe, at Tim Hortons. Quick sketch, he got up and left for sure. I know that because I think I would have finished drawing his bottom part there. I started using Micron pens again, those fine line markers. They come in all different widths. But I started off years ago, when I started my art career, I started doing illustrations, more illustration-based drawings, paintings of independent Toronto coffee houses. And I did a whole series of those in Micron pen drawings with watercolor. And they actually, thinking back to that time, they probably were one of my proudest series of drawings I've ever done. But anyways, returning to these Micron pen drawings, I tried doing it again. And I have to say they lack a certain life in the line work compared to my ballpoint pen drawings. So it was a nice revisit down memory lane. And you know what? I might revisit that medium in the future. Back at my welding school, they have this drill press I've drawn before. This is from a different angle. Again, trying to draw what's in the foreground, but also adding stuff in the background. And how do you depict it? So I did it by doing some heavy line work on this foreground drill press, and then in the background, very light line work for that lathe, I guess it was. Self-portrait. What can I say about that? I didn't get myself that. This was not a good drawing of me, for sure. But practice makes perfect, no? This next drawing was done on the subway, or two subway trips. This particular gentleman was having a snooze, and he had a milk crepe beside him, so I liked how his hand turned out in this drawing, and then this lady was snoozing as well, right across from me. And she had this fierce grimace on his face, on her face while she snoozed. Some more practice drawings of portraits from earthsworld.com, I believe. Again, if you want portrait drawing practice, I suggest you go there, earthsworld.com. Whole series of unique looking individuals, and it's a great resource. And this last drawing for this week of February 11th to February 17th is this particular gentleman on the subway, and then I had to take apart my kitchen faucet and replace it with a new faucet because it was leaking, and so I had these faucet parts lying around, and I decided to sketch it using that square method tutorial that I put together to try to draw that oval. I think it worked out quite well there, and that is it. I hope you enjoyed this week. If you have any questions about anything, really, drop them in the comment section below. Have a great week. Have a great next week. I'll see you then. Bye for now.